Once you've powered up your GrooveRio for the first time and logged in with your new admin account, there are a couple of additional tasks you'll want to take care of to get the most out of your device. One of those is installing and configuring the Groove I/O nodes and starting to use Node-RED. So we'll start by going to our Node-RED menu and enabling the Node-RED runtime, and then I'll go ahead and use this video to show you how to install the Groove I/O nodes, how to configure them, and how to do some of the very basics. Now, here we can see I've enabled the Node-RED runtime, and we can see that the CPU usage has calmed down. You don't want to launch it right away since Node-RED won't be ready, but now that we can see that it's just running in the background, I can go ahead and open the Node-RED editor. Right away, we can see it opens a new tab, and I have this flow workspace here, my node palette on the left-hand side, and my info and debug panes here on the right-hand side. The next thing I wanted to do is add the GrooveIO nodes to this palette. So to do that, I'll come up to the main menu in the top right here and select Manage Palette. Here we can see all the nodes that are already installed, including the pre-installed core nodes that come with Node-RED right out of the box. To add a new node, I will need an internet connection, and once I have that, I can just come over to this Install tab and search for anything I want to add. So here I'll just type in GrooveIO, and we can see the node right here. So to add it, I just click Install, confirm the installation, and wait for it to come down. I shouldn't take on any extra tasks while it's doing this since it's busy in the background, but I can keep up with its progress by just selecting View Log right here, and we'll see that it's coming down. Now, we might see some warnings here pop up as the node is installing, but many of these are just precautionary, and as long as the node comes down, they're not a problem. So we'll just sit, wait for the process to complete, and we'll be able to use our nodes without any problems. So there we go. We can see that the packages have been added and we have a return code of 0, meaning there were no errors. We can also see this green pop-up saying all the nodes that are added to our palette, and if we close the node palette manager, we can just scroll down right here on the node palette and see that all the nodes were in fact successfully added without needing to restart Node-RED. So let's drag one in starting at the top and begin to configure it. You can see as soon as you drag one in, there's this red triangle at the top there. That means that there is no configuration yet. So we'll go ahead and double click it, and we can see that we need to add a new GrooveIO device. So I'll just select this pencil icon here, and we can see that we are brought to the default of localhost. Since Node-RED is running on the Rio that I want to read and write from right now, I can leave that as localhost, but I could communicate with other GrooveIO devices as well. Now I just need to put in my API key. This application programming interface key essentially gives Node-RED permission to access the I/O. Even though they're running on the same device, it's still a secure application and our I/O is actually secure, so we need to go ahead and put this API key in. To find that, I'll just go back to Groove Manage, go to the home screen and select Accounts. I could add an extra account here for Node-RED specifically, that way I could manage things separately, but I'll just go ahead and use the system-wide administrator key. So now I just come down here, highlight the entire API key, and copy it to my clipboard. If this key ever does become insecure or leaked or anything like that, I can go ahead and generate a new key, and any application that's using this will need to have that key put in again. So this is a good security option, but keep in mind where you put the key before you generate a new one, since it will need to be replaced. So now that I have that key copied to my clipboard, I'll just go back to Node-RED, paste that into my API key, and click Add. Now we can see I have my localhost device configured, and I just need to figure out the data type, module index, and channel index. Now if you know exactly what you want to read in, you can probably end the video here, but I'm going to go ahead and check what options I have available, and we'll see how to configure this. So I'll go back to Groove Manage, leave the account selection screen, and go into I/O channels. Here we can see I already have some I/O channels configured, and I'm going to go ahead and select this top button digital input. You can see that it's on channel 0 and we are on module 0 since it's GrooveRio with only one module. So this button is going to be what I want to read in. So I'll go back to Node-RED. I'll leave it as digital state change since I'm reading in a digital button press. I'll put in the module 0, the channel number of 0, and I'll give this a name like read button. So now I can just click done, and we'll see that red triangle disappeared. We just have the blue circle, meaning we haven't deployed yet. Now, I want to be able to see this output, so I'll go ahead and push and hold left control, left click on my workspace, and that'll show this quick add menu where I can just drop in a debug node and wire that in right away. Now, I just click deploy, and we'll see right away in our debug we have a notification that the button is off. If I go ahead and press the button, we'll get the value true, and if I disable it again, we get the value false, so it's working right away. Now, there are more options besides just this input node that scans the value and lets us know when it is updated. I can also read the value whenever I want. And you'll notice as soon as I drag this in, I again do get that red triangle, but if I double click this node and drop down the device, Groove.io device, we can see that the localhost is saved. This configuration will work between all Groove.io nodes I bring in, we only have to do the API key that one time. If you want to see where that configuration is saved or make any changes to it, go ahead and come up to the top right menu and select Configuration Nodes. You can see here is my Groove.io device. It is used on two nodes, denoted by the number 2 there, and if I select it, we can go ahead and see all of the nodes that are using it. If I want to make any changes to it, I just double click it, and we'll see this is the standard pop-up here where I could replace the API key or make any other changes I need to do. So I'll just go ahead and close this, and we'll see how to use this Groove.io read node. This one, rather than regularly scanning the output, requires input in order to read what value we're looking for. So I'll go back to my I/O channels and we'll read in this analog input on channel 3. We can see this is a temperature reading and that's what I want to pull in, but only when I specifically inject into the flow that I want to read it. So I'll go back to Node-RED, select my digital channel, and I'll change that to analog channel since I want to read in that analog temperature value. I'll put in my module number of 0, my channel number of 3, and we'll make this something like read temperature. So now when I click done, we'll also have to add an input node on this. So this time I'll scroll up to the top, drag in an inject node, wire that in, drag in a debug node, and wire that in as well. So now when I click deploy, and switch back to my debug pane, I'll just clear that up so I can see this clearly. We'll see that I'm not seeing the temperature at all, but when I inject, there we go, that's the current temperature, and now that it's in Node-RED, I can use it however I want. Now, as well as reading data in and just showing it in the debug pane or moving it around between different nodes, I can also write to different outputs. So I'll also bring in a Groove.io write node, and let's select a channel that we can write to. Now we'll just go back and we'll use this blue ring LED digital output on channel 4 in order to demonstrate this writing. So I'll drag that off to the side. We'll double click my Groove.io write node and we'll select our localhost configuration. And we do want to leave it as the digital output channel state since that's what we want to write at this point. I'll go ahead and put in my module index of 0, my channel index of 4, and we'll make this something like toggle light. So now that that's all filled in, I'll just click done, and we'll need to inject something here as well. So I'll make a copy of this inject node and of this debug node. But this time, we don't want to inject something random like a timestamp, we want to inject the value we want to write. In this case, we can just go ahead and click done, select the Groove write node, we can come over to the info tab, and here we can see the values that it's expecting. Here we can see to turn on the channel, we need to send either true or on, and to turn it off, we need to send false or off. So that's exactly what I'll do. I'll make a copy of this node here, and we'll switch that from instead of sending the timestamp, we'll switch it to the Boolean value true, and we'll switch the other one to the Boolean value of false. So we'll just use this drop down here, select false, and wire these in. So now our toggle light will be controlled by these true and false inject nodes, and we'll be able to confirm it with this message payload output here in this debug node. So now I can go ahead and click deploy, and when I bring in my value here, we can see that it's turned off right now. We'll toggle it true, and we can see that the state has turned to true, and we'll toggle it false, and we can see our state has changed to false. So now I can bring in any other Groove.io nodes, use that same configuration, I don't have to put my API key in again, and I'm easily able to read and write different I/O points on the Groove.io from Node-RED right out of the box.